So let's have a look at important multiple choice questions from the subject Construction Planning and Management, that is CPM. And today's topic for MCQ is Introduction and Basics of Construction Planning and Management. So the question in front of us is saying that a project is, option A is saying, an endless activity that assures quality of desired product. See, a project cannot be a series of endless activities, okay? This is wrong. Then a series of activities bound to finite time period to produce a result. Yes, this can be the answer. It is a series of activities bound to finite time period. This is important term here, to produce a result, to create a desired output. Okay, let's see what option C is saying. Planning for a series of events to generate a result. See, obviously planning is there. Planning is must in a project, but project is just not planning. It is planning, then scheduling, then controlling, then execution, then resources. Means a lot of parameters are involved in a project. Therefore, option C is also wrong. Option B is the one. Okay, let's have some detailed discussion regarding this C. A project is a series of activities bound to finite time period to produce a result. And project involves planning of the project, then scheduling, then actuation, means initiation of the project, then execution, then resources need to be identified, resources need to be allocated, then quality control and prodification in the ongoing project should be done, can be done, then the project is completed in order to have the desired output. Therefore, project involves all these number of parameters, okay, less or more these parameters. Okay, this is what a project is. Let's move to question number next. A project has objective or objectives such as, do we optimize the material requirement? Yes, certainly yes. Do we optimize the manpower? Yes, we do. Do we optimize finance, budget, money? Yes, we do. Therefore, all of the above constraints are what? Objectives of project. Okay. See, a project has objectives such as budget and quality. Okay, all these things have to be balanced, have to be optimized. If we restrict the budget, we cannot get quality. If we just focus on quality, then budget gets collapsed. Therefore, a balance needs to be made. We have to make balance in between time span. We cannot just allow a large time span so as to have maximum quality. We cannot employ the whole manpower. We cannot use each and every material. We cannot go to any extent to use any material. But we do have to look what client is demanding in his project. What is his expectation? What is the desired output for his project? Then we have to keep the quality control so that whatever the client is demanding, whatever his desired output is there, we should have control on the quality so that it should not deviate much because of we are trying to economize the project. Okay. Therefore, a balance needs to be there in between budget and quality. Therefore, we are optimizing material, we are optimizing manpower, we are optimizing money, we are optimizing quality, we are optimizing the time scheduling for the project. Okay, therefore, all these are the objective of project, of the optimization of the given parameter. All right, let's move to question number next. Arrange the phases of project management in correct order, and we have been given with scheduling, planning and controlling. Okay, first thing that we do whenever we are given with a project is we plan all the things that are going to get converted into events and activity. Therefore, this should be the number one thing. Then we schedule it, means we allocate the resources. Then we plan the timeline. Okay, scheduling means giving the time constraint which was done in planning phase. Okay, means giving the specific time constraint to the activity is done in scheduling. Therefore, scheduling is number two. Then controlling. In controlling, whatever the ongoing activities are there, these activities are controlled for quality, for quantity, for resources, for manpower, for money. Okay, this should be number three. Therefore, the correct option that goes with our sequence is option C. 2, 1, 3. Planning, scheduling, then controlling. Okay, C. First thing comes planning, which is direction of work is set up, then resources are identified. Okay, whatever material, money, manpower are identified for their quantity and quality in planning phase. Then the second phase comes as scheduling. We do allocate the resources with respect to the need, the timing and the requirements of the ongoing activities. And then finally, we control, we monitor, we supervise all the processes, all the activities, events going on in the project, and we make necessary changes with respect to the need of the project, the need of the time, the need of the client, the demands of the client. Okay, therefore, planning, scheduling, and controlling are the three phases of any project. Okay, fill in the blank is not a part. Okay, focus the word. Fill in the blank is not the part of planning phase of project. Resource identification. Do we identify the resources in planning phase? Yes, we do. We quantify, means we quality wise and quantity wise identify the necessary resources, whether they are in the form of money, manpower or time, material. Okay, in planning phase. Do we allocate the resources in planning phase? No, we don't. We allocate the resources in which phase? Scheduling phase. Okay, then estimation of resources is done in planning. Therefore, resource allocation is not part of planning. Okay, identification is and estimation is, but not allocation. Okay, see, planning consists of work direction, resource identification and resource estimation. Okay, quantity, quality of the material is identified, then direction of work, then flow of activities is set in planning. But whenever we are saying we are allocating the resources, we do it in scheduling. We do it in scheduling of the project, scheduling phase of the project. All right. Okay. Question number 5 saying, if fluctuation in quality and quantity requirements of an activity are observed, then in order to maintain desired progress of project, changes are carried out in fill in the blank phase. Now the phase is, planning is there, scheduling is there, controlling is there and maintenance is there. Okay, planning is not the answer. We identify the things in planning. We allocate the things in scheduling. This thing, changes in the ongoing activities is done in controlling. See, maintenance is not even a phase in project. Maintenance takes place only after the project is completed. Therefore, the phases of project include only three things: planning, scheduling, and controlling. We do all these things in the controlling phase. Okay. See, controlling the budget for getting the desired output means a budget may need to be maximized. The budget may need to be increased with respect to the changes which are desirable in the project. Manpower need to be fluctuated. Okay, manpower may need to be reduced or increased with respect to the ongoing activities when quality or quantity deviation is taking place. Then time span may need to be increased so as to gain the desired output. Therefore, controlling phase has all these constraints that can be changed, that can be taken control over. Okay, let's move to question number next. Bar charts are also known as, what do we call bar chart? Simplistic chart? Yes, they are simple, but we don't call them with this name, this term, simplistic chart. Column chart? Okay, there may be column in bar chart, but column chart and the bar chart we are going to deal in construction planning and management are not just column chart. Gantt chart? Yes. See, Henry Gantt introduced the chart, the bar chart, which are useful, which are utilizable in construction planning and management in the year 1900. Okay, 1900 AD. Okay, that's why they are also known as by the name of the person who invented, who introduced them. Okay, and the Gantt chart looks something like this. Okay, these are the activities which are shown across y-axis and time span goes along x-axis. Okay, y-axis is for activities, x-axis is for time span, and these bars are identifying what activities which are required in any project. Okay, so in a bar chart or Gantt chart, x-axis represents what and y-axis represents what. We just saw this, we just saw a Gantt chart or bar chart. Okay, in x-axis, on x-axis we are representing time. Okay, and on y-axis we are putting activities. See, time is shown on x-axis and activities are shown on y-axis. Okay, all these are what? Various activities which are shown along the y-axis, along the vertical axis, and the time required for initiation and completion of that specific activity is shown on x-axis. Let's say this is 0 day, 1, 2, 3, or it can be shown in various scales. The scale may be hours, the scale may be days, the scale may be weeks, or the scale may be months or year. In case the project is very, very big, very, very long time taking, then it can be shown in years also. Okay, advantages of using a bar chart is ease of reading and understanding. Yes, they are very easy to read and they can be understood by any level of personnel. Yes. Time required for an activity completion can be clearly determined. Yes, the x-axis clearly shows the time which is required for an activity. Therefore, we can easily determine by the visual inspection, we can see what is the time constraint required for that specific activity. Yes, interdependencies of the activities can be determined. Can we? No, we can't. See, for example, this is activity number one, this is activity number two. We cannot see what is the interdependency of activities going on in between these two activities. All the activities which are shown on a bar chart are look like they are independent of each other. They are having their specific individual progression. Okay, interdependencies of activity cannot be seen. Okay, therefore this is the problem with respect to the bar chart. Progress of the work can be seen. See, progress of the activity can be seen, but the progress of total work, the total project progress, cannot be directly seen from a bar chart. Therefore, this is also another problem with respect to bar chart, because a bar chart shows initiation of the activity and completion of the activity. What is happening with the total project work cannot be directly determined by using a bar chart. Therefore, the correct option we can see here is option D, 1 and 2. Okay, let's take a detailed look in this. See, for example, we are having a project in which three activities are there: excavation, then mixing of concrete, and procurement of material. Okay, see, excavation is looking like independent activity, then procurement of the material is looking at independent activity, mixing of concrete is looking at independent activity. See, and this overlap here. Procurement of material for any construction project needs reinforcement, then sand, then cement, then mixing material, then tools, then labors. But this specific thing, mixing of concrete, is starting just before procurement of material is ending. Therefore, we cannot exactly say what specific material we are procuring. Are we procuring cement, concrete, sand, water, all these things, or tools, machinery required for mixing? Means the interdependency cannot be depicted from this simplistic approach bar chart, and the whole progress of the work cannot be seen. Means it is not possible just to look at the final activity in the whole project and just say that the project is complete, the total work has been completed. Therefore, this is the advantage of bar chart, that only ease of reading is provided and time constraint for activity completion is seen. We cannot discuss about interdependencies or progress of the total project. Okay, let's move to question number 9. Yes, 9. A bar chart should be used for, okay, where we should use a bar chart? Project involving critical and non-critical activities? No, critical and non-critical activities should not be accessed by using a bar chart, because we just saw interdependency linking of the activities cannot be depicted by using a bar chart or Gantt chart. Okay, then project with interdependence, exactly the word we just said regarding a bar chart, this cannot be used. And project with simplistic sequence of activities. Yes, when a project is small, when a project is having simple activities sequence in between them, then we can use a bar chart. Therefore, all of the above is getting ruled out here. Option C is the correct one. Okay, let's see what the discussion is saying. See, a bar chart should be used for a project with simplistic sequence of activities. For example, a small work of construction of a compound wall is there. Then all the small tasks, that is procurement of material, excavation for that compound wall, then mixing of concrete, then procurement of reinforcement. This specific project of compound wall is so small that the activities can be presented by using a bar chart, because number of constraints required for that specific project are so small that a bar chart will not have any confusion, any ambiguity while presenting the data to the user, to the person who is accessing that specific series of activities. Okay, that's why a bar chart should be used for a project with simple, easy to read, easy to understand, easy to present sequence of activities. So that was all regarding the introductory and basic part of construction planning and management. Hope you like the video. Press the like button, comment what you liked about the video, share with your friends, and do subscribe to Simplified Learning. Take care, stay in home, and bye bye.